And I think it's another, it's the personal relationships that have developed, you know, over time. It's, you know, I know who I want taking care of my patients. I know, you know, what their expertise is, their skills. And I think those personal relationships, I mean, you know, it's you would think it should just be this easy that we could, all physicians should be able to do this, and we should. And that's not the standard out there, but I think it can become the standard. But it's the personal relationships that develop, and being able to, when I call Dr. Fitzke, he knows exactly what I'm getting him into, you know, what the issue is, you know. And with regard to carcinoid, a couple different carcinoid patients he's operated on, you know, he's not going into this necessarily just with a scan and some patient history. He's going into this hopefully with a pretty good understanding of what I've assessed the situation to be. And I got to hope that helps the patient in the OR. It certainly helps them postoperatively. And as we take care of these patients postoperatively, I knowing what they did, them knowing what I've done, just furthers the care. And it doesn't allow for details that, you know, can't be missed to be missed.
Terrific. Well, I think, why don't we turn to more specific questions? And I think that this terrific model of collaboration will continue to be seen with your dialogue about what we will discuss next. So, Dr. Botha, let's turn to you and discuss specifically what types of surgery you specialize in and how long you've been practicing and the nitty-gritty of your practice.
Sure. So, I've been hepatic or liver surgeon for probably close to 10 years now. My primary speciality is liver transplantation here at the medical center. We have a huge non-transplant hepatobiliary practice, so my time is split between transplantation and non-transplant liver surgery, which takes up most of what I do. In doing that, I'm ably supported and, you know, allowed some room to be able to do some fairly aggressive things. And I've been, you know, that gets back to the Nebraska Medical Center supporting me in that effort and the partners that I have, and have allowed us to do some things which are fairly radical, and notwithstanding our patients that have allowed us to do some of these things as well. But in terms of aggressive surgery, I like to think that we're at the forefront of doing what is the most cutting-edge hepatic surgery in terms of aggressiveness, moving you know, the ability to resect forward, being able to take more and more pieces of liver out, allowing liver to regenerate. So there are a bunch of things that we're able to offer here, from simple things like laparoscopic liver resection to laparoscopic radiofrequency ablation, percutaneous radiofrequency ablation, in terms of the surgical therapies, open surgery to massive liver resections. We're comfortable in removing, you know, 75% of somebody's liver, knowing that the remainder is going to regenerate. The newer things that we've done more recently are staged liver resections, taking out portions of one side of the liver, allowing the remainder to regenerate, and then go and take out the remaining tumor in the liver. We use things like portal vein embolization to stimulate regeneration of a future liver remnant. And again, liver transplantation is always an option for us and our patients who have neuroendocrine or carcinoid tumors, as a means to further enhance long-term survival. So we feel like we're doing the latest and the greatest and trying to push the margins of what's doable, while, you know, getting back to how long we've been doing it, I mean, I've been here only 7 years, 5 years as an attending surgeon. I did my transplant training here for the first 2 years. So, again, neuroendocrine tumors are rare. Carcinoid is rare. So any one surgeon doesn't accumulate tons of those in a short period of time. So while we haven't got huge numbers and huge results to be able to publish at this point in time, I suspect that will happen over the next few years.
And so let's talk about the patients that you have seen. Talk about maybe how many neuroendocrine tumor patients you have seen and what kind of damage to the organs that you've seen as a surgeon.
So I've mainly been referred patients who have metastatic liver disease from the neuroendocrine tumors. Offhand, I can already count, you know, 15 patients that I've seen over the last 5 years. 10 probably in the last year, as we've, you know, Ruth has allowed us to do something aggressive to her initially, and this has spawned a number of patients being referred here and coming here. But, you know, just in the last year, I've seen probably I can recall straight off 10 patients with carcinoid tumors, metastatic to the liver. All the patients I've seen are patients with metastatic tumors. So
first, let me just explain. Ruth Gerdes is a patient of yours. She is the reason why we're all here today. She has been extremely generous in sharing her story with all of us patients and in creating kind of the instrument of your collaboration. And we're going to talk a little bit more about her surgery. She's very graciously agreed to allow us to talk about it because it sounds like a very aggressive and new procedure that you performed.
Absolutely. I'd read about this procedure. There's a French group, a leading French liver surgery group in Paris, that had published this technique in patients with metastatic colon cancer to the liver. A small number of patients, but had reported fairly good results in patients who were otherwise considered inoperable with large tumor bulk in their liver. they then hadn't published anything for a while, and Ruth came along and had this sort of ideal scenario of where she had a large bulk of tumor in the liver, which would have normally been considered not resectable because of the bilobar involvement, both sides of the liver being involved. And discussing it with her, I thought, you know, this is something I had not done yet, but was quite willing to do. And she was otherwise young, otherwise healthy, and I felt would have tolerated aggressive surgery. And she agreed to go through with this, and we've seen a very good result. And we've done it again, and we will continue to do it based on the good results. And in this year subsequent to this, we've been vindicated. That same French group has published earlier this year in an eminent surgical journal their results on 21 patients, I think it was, with metastatic neuroendocrine tumors that they've applied this technique to, with superb results. We're talking about 80% survival at 8 years.
Which is so exciting, and we'll make sure to have that article available on the Nebraska Medical Center website and also on the Caring for Carcinoid Foundation website, just so patients and doctors know that they can know where to find it.
Right.
So that's very exciting.
Phenomenal results, and again, hopefully we can duplicate these results over time with applying these strategies. And it's aggressive surgery, but the results are now, there's ample results showing that aggressive surgical resection, removal of 90 to 100% of the metastatic disease results in obviously relief of symptoms, but does improve long-term survival. And obviously Ruth did not have symptoms, her carcinoid did not secrete, but this was with the goal of improving her long-term survival, and hopefully we will achieve that.
It's very exciting, and from what I have spoken with to Ruth, she's very excited about it as well. And so I think this is a great example of another example of collaboration, that the kind of collaboration we were speaking about earlier. So Drs. Fitzky and Zaruba, what did you think when you first heard about this procedure that Dr. Botha proposed doing? What came across your minds when you first thought about performing it, being involved with it?
No.
Go ahead.
Well, you know,
I'd be interested to hear this answer because I don't think I've heard it yet.
Yeah, I don't think we've ever talked about this. You know, I think from, you know, I have to back up just a little bit. You know, Ruth was, when she came to me, I knew we had a big problem. And I'll be very honest about where I was at. I wasn't really sure what we needed to do. But I knew, you know, we could work on this. I knew we could research it and we could figure out some answers. And we came to Dr. Botha through, you talk about collaboration, we came to Dr. Botha through a third-year medical student. Dr. Fitzky had performed the primary resection and had suggested that we get Ruth to a liver surgeon. At the time, Ruth's nephew was here at the Nebraska Medical Center, and it was kind of a collaborative effort among all of us to get to Dr. Botha. And I can tell you, after all the research I had done, and I had done a lot of research and talked to a lot of experts, I knew immediately that this was the right way to go. I knew from doing the research and looking at things that surgery